And welcome back, everybody, to Paul Plays Minecraft. Today is January the 3rd. Wait. Calendar. Line. The 3rd. Right, it's the 3rd. Oops. And 2013. Wait a minute, what is this? Cool. I never look at stats. That's so weird. That button's been here for how many years, and I've never actually looked at it. Or if I have, I've forgotten. But these numbers cannot be right. There's no way. 145 times played. I've played a lot more than that. 9 worlds. Now this must be just for this folder. See, I keep my all my Minecraft worlds for the various series that I do in separate folders. So I just swap them out when I need to play a particular series. So yeah, this is definitely not right. Number of deaths. I have not died in Paul Plays Minecraft, but I have died in the past in some series. So, and I have killed people. Well, not. I mean, in Minecraft, I've got 26 fish. Yeah, that's not right. But you know what would be interesting is going through and tallying up all those numbers with all of my various worlds. I'd like to see that. There's somebody out here, fella. Oh! There's a pigman. He's back. Oh! Pigman, you're back. Back from the nether to visit. Oh, there he is, down here in the grotto. Ooh! I see you've made friends. Friends in low places. Ah! More than one. There's a creeper in the creeper vine here. Let me get him. Creeper creeping. More ways than one. So, Mr. Pigman, I hope you're enjoying your stay here in the surface world. Don't get any ideas, though. He needs a name, that little guy. He comes and visits now and then. He just comes and he goes as he pleases. Tea and crumpets occasionally together out on the deck. So I think we should give him a name, and I'm thinking something zombie pigmanish, like Zub, no, Zippy, Ziggy. How's Ziggy? Ziggy's kind of cool. All right, Ziggy the Pigman. He's chilling outside, enjoying the jungle, before he has to go back to the oppressive heat and ash and dust in the Nether. Anyway, let's get back to Minecraft here. And projects. So I did clearly move my brewing stand over here. I'm trying to keep all of my work area in this section over here and keep that free of any obstruction. So I've built up a couple of chests. I put all my brewing ingredients here. Next to the laboratory. And over here we have the smithing materials next to the smithy. And I have, let's see, 3 awkward potions ready to roll. Ready for some cooking, and what I wanted to cook today are a few potions for an adventure. So I want fire resistance. So we're going to make fire resistance potions, and in the meantime, let's grab some more water. Dump that out. I like the cauldron. Now I know I can make a... I realize I can make an infinite water spring, but I like the way the cauldron looks, and I like because it's more, I don't know. I want to use the word realistic. I realize this is Minecraft, it's a game, and it's not realistic, but I like to have my homes make sense. And this has a purpose. It was built and made and put into the game to use it. So rather than just use it as a bathtub or a sink and make it look pretty, I want to use it for what it was made for. That's just how I play the old Minecraft. Now, I want to make, all right, 8-minute fire resistance, that's perfect. And I also wanted to make an invisibility potion, which means I'm going to need a golden carrot. Whoops, get over here, man. And we do this like that, if I remember. Digging deep into the memory reserves here. Golden carrot. And I think I need a fermented spider eye, because what you have to do is make night vision potions first. Right, so the golden carrot makes a night vision, and then we hit it with some of this fermented spider eye, and that makes it into invisibility. We'll play a little Bilbo Baggins sneaking around with his invisibility ring. I would love to find a stronghold. I don't want to turn all of those into invisibility. I want to keep one night vision. I want to find a stronghold. So we're going to get some ender pearls pretty soon, maybe today. And then turn them into ender eye. And I think I need, or eyes of ender, rather. And I need blaze powder for that, right? It's been a while. And there we go. Invisibility. Let's put a pinch of redstone in there, make it last a little longer. And I think we're ready to roll. Bum, bum, bum. So I've been carrying this golden apple and the weakness potion around in the hopes of running in, bumping into a zombie villager out there and repopulating my town, my neighbor's place next door. All right, here we go. But, what? You know what? Let's go run over there. Here, let's go do that. Let's go do that. Come here, buddy. Whoops. Hey, are you up or you down? What are you doing? Uh-oh. You're not really there, are you? What's up with my dog? Uh-oh. That's not cool. Ziggy! Alright, so we have Ziggy in the grotto. We have chicken and a biscuit. Or bush, depending on how you see things. And we have a dog that doesn't move. Hello, chickens. Morning to you. Top of the morning to you, chickenses. Let's breed them up and let's slaughter them. I need more feathers. There we go. Love Shack, baby Love Shack. San says, get away, fool. Ah, oh, I'm sorry. I won't sing anymore. I think you're the last guy, huh? Always the third wheel inside these walls. I know. Sorry. Oh, that poor guy was suffering anyway without a girlfriend. Or a boyfriend. We need a lily pad. Don't we? I think we're gonna go on a quest today. A quest for lily pads. Alright, for now I'm just gonna dump this stuff in here so I don't have to go back in the house. That was meant for here. Hey, what are you doing here? You should come with me. But first I wanted to go check on the villagers. Because here's what somebody had mentioned in one of the... Whoa. What are her... Maybe not. In a comment, someone had mentioned that in the same seed that they're playing, the same map, they found villagers up in that building up there, the tall one. So we're going to go check on that. Maybe they got stuck up there. There's no access up there. I can see the door from here, in fact. So maybe the zombies couldn't get to them. My guess is zombies... Cause I'm pretty sure I checked that whole place out. My guess is zombies spawned inside there with them and just ate them. Because there ain't nobody over here. There's no lights on over here at home. No lights at home. Because I do want to get this repopulated so we can get some trading going. Back off. Alright. Fingers and toes and claws crossed. Nope. Knew it. Dang it. Yeah, they probably... Zombies probably spawned in here and ate them. So let's light it up for the future when I come back and I repopulate this town. For the good of 2013 and a prosperous future here in the village of Roanoke, Virginia. What's the old village where all those people disappeared? Is it Roanoke? In like the 1500s? Yeah, a whole bunch of people. Like the whole town. Just poof, gone. What's up with that? I would imagine they didn't get eaten by zombies. They probably fell victim to some sort of plague. Or maybe they were mutilated. I don't know. But I don't think anybody really knows. But it's a mystery that has never been solved. And it's just kind of intriguing. But I think the same thing happened to my guys. No, I know what happened to my guys here. They get it. And what I have to do, my responsibility as a good neighbor, is to protect them after repopulating. And in doing so, I'm going to have to put up some iron doors so they don't get kicked in. And just lock them in so they can't cause trouble. Yeah, that's a problem. They got to get Ed anyway. I'll have to, you know what? I'll just light up the whole place. And maybe I'll put fencing around it. That's what I'll do because they won't be able to open the iron doors to get inside. So that doesn't make any sense. Oh, I was hoping something spontaneously spawned in there, but no. I should... All right, today was not Help Your Neighbor Day. Today was talk about 2013 and the cool stuff coming down the pike on my channel that you guys may be interested in. Oh, it's getting night. And also, wondering about New Year's resolutions. Yeah. Did you guys come up with anything good? It's the time of year when you make promises to yourself and your friends or loved ones or whoever, family. Ooh, that's bad. And you promise to change for the better. You want to become a better person. Or you want to do something that you're not used to doing or you should do and stop doing things that you shouldn't do. And we make wild promises, right? Everybody goes, yay. But we all know the truth of it. Change isn't that easy, sadly. But we can make an effort. A for effort. Oh, hello. I'll just use my diamond sword on you. So, I have some resolutions that I guess I can share some of them, but most are private. And things that I kind of do some things that I like to change. And, most of those are private, so I can't talk about them here. And do they not come true if you talk about it, or is that just wishes? I'm going to go with that. I can't talk about it because they won't come true. But, hey, bad spider. So let's talk about what I can control, and it doesn't really have anything, and it's more public, and that would be my Minecraft channel, and that has something to do with the game and you, so keep it OP. I mean OT, OP, overpowered, on topic, is the real acronym I was looking for there. Boink. So, speaking of the channel, what I want to do is, get a more consistent... I keep hearing things. Get a more consistent... schedule. Oh, that word hurts when I say it. Ow! Stop saying schedule! And organize... Ow! That hurts. Schedules and organization. but that's really the way we need to go on my channel, I think, because I'm at the point now. Let's go get some... Some dudes over here. Whoa! Dudes. Those, you know, the black and white things over there. The big guys that walk around. Big milk. Cows. I need to light all this up. Zombie villager? Zombie villager? No. Whatever. My dog! What the heck is going on with my dog? Here, quick. Before you get blown up. I'll go this way. Draw them off. So I want to come up with a schedule. I want to have like a regular time when you can expect a particular video or series of videos. Like yesterday, for example, let me give you an example. Yesterday was Wednesday, and I put out three videos, and they were my kind of from my role-playing series repertoire, I guess. So I did Tale of Kingdoms, right? And what else did I do? I did Tale of Kingdoms, and I did who's the lonesome dove here? That guy over there. Let's go get him. I don't want to kill a mommy or a daddy. I did Tale of Kingdoms, Man vs. Minecraft, and even a Skyrim. Skyrim! Love it! It's been so long. Ooh, give me that. No! Oh, dang, you ruined my free-range pasture. Jerk. Stinking bum. All right, let's clean this up then. At least no cows are killed in the making of this video. Well... By that creeper, anyway. I may have slaughtered one or two by my own hands. It doesn't count. Because that is for necessary, for that's for survival, you see. That's okay. Maybe not according to you, my friend, but according to everybody else. Did I kill one of you? Yeah, I probably did. I don't remember. I will save you from this fiend. Make up for it. There you go. So, let me eat. Yes, I just ate your cousin. Sorry. He's tasty. I'm gonna wash it down with a tater tot. Now run off, you little creep. I love the animals in Minecraft. They're so funny. Anyway, so we're gonna tighten up a little bit and do like a schedule. So Wednesday will be like roleplay day. That was the point I was making before I got sidetracked by creepers and cows. Whoa! Oh, ah, chicken, watch it! Whoa. Superman creeper here. You laughing? Yeah, I know I missed three times. Shush it. I won't miss you. Again, tighten up the offerings and have a schedule. So Wednesday, for example, will be roleplay day. And then on Monday, I'll do like maybe tutorial day or something. And don't hold me to this schedule. This is just, I'm just thinking out loud. Oh, this is bad. What's going on, dog? How did you get all buggered? Huh. I don't know. And then I'll do, you know, Paul Plays Minecraft will be actually a couple times a week. So that might not be in a schedule. But the ones that I don't do as often, I would like to schedule so that you can expect them and know when they're coming down. And I need some more torches. Oh my gosh. Oh, I need coal, don't I? I have no coal left in this series. That's what I need. Let's go get some coal. And I want to go to a swamp. I'm going to run in one direction. Oh, I said it. One direction. Swear word. I'm going to go in one direction and see if I can find stronghold or a ravine. So we're going to go pick a direction to go in right now. And let's do this. I'm going to put all my raw meat in here. And then we'll talk as I travel. 47 hours. See, I have no coal. We're going to have to go find a cave and do some coal digging. Ooh, wow. That's a first. Now, I know this cave's over here, but I've already been in there. Did I find a mine shaft in this world? See, here's the other thing I need to do. Get more consistent and... Whoa! And have a plan with things to talk about, like a topic or something to do before I get on and start recording. It's something I don't usually do. Get away from my cocoa bean. Creeper. Hey. Oh, my chicken. You tried to blow up my chicken in a biscuit, didn't you? Tasty treat. So, and also, just get more content out. If I can. So more consistency, tighten up the schedule, and that way, you know those cliffhangers I always leave you guys with? Don't you hate that? Don't you hate those cliffhangers? Like yesterday I did the Skyrim, I was like, okay, actually it was the episode before. We're gonna go up the stairs on three. One, two, three! Fade to black, to be continued. And that's an old trick of old TV. It's been around since the days of the caveman. I think when they were drawing cave drawings, like the cave guy would be like making a... I'm so sad I don't have my dog. He's a buggered. I gotta fix that. So the cave drawing guy, like the first artist, was making this cartoon on the wall. And it was a guy in a cave suit running from T-Rexes. Even though they weren't really together. But he had a great imagination. Oh, sun's on the rise. I should kill cows out here because these guys are not my cows. Somebody else's cows and he won't mind so much. And I need sheepsies. I'm just going to run toward the sun. Sun's rising, so it's east. So the cave guy who did this cave drawing, right? He said... He left it. The caveman was running from... Well, he opened up... He went inside a cave and there was a giant T-Rex. And he took out his spear. And then he stopped drawing the cave drawings. And everybody was like... And that means like, dude, what happened? Seriously, you can't leave us hanging. Because then he left. Because then the other cave guy went to go get lunch. And he was eating some kind of... you know, like Brontosaurus burger. What am I talking about? Ooh, swap! So the other guy's like, no, you finished the story. But then when the guy walked out of the cave to go get his Brontosaurus burger, he turned around, like, kind of laughing. Like, ha ha ha, you have to wait till I get back after my lunch. And he slipped off the cliff, because the cave was on a cliff, you see. And he fell off the cliff, and he got squished at the bottom. It's a long way down, like a couple thousand feet or something. So then he never got to finish the story, and all the other cave men and ladies were like, oh, yeah. They were sad because they never really found out what happened. And that was the first cliffhanger. So, yeah, cliffhangers stink. Yeah, they never found out. It's terrible. I have no idea where that just came from, but that was goofy. Ooh, I should get some clay. So, anyway, so that's what cliffhangers do. So they go back way back. That's right. And so I do those because it's supposed to keep you coming back for more. That's the whole point. Oh, you know what I'd like to get would be some dark wood. Bring some of that back. Because I haven't seen a pine forest anywhere. Plenty of swamp. I've got vines coming out of my ears, but I don't have pine wood or lily pads. I do now. Those lily pads are going to look nice. I can put that in the farm, remember? That spot in the farm. Am I full? No. Get over here, you. Yeah, where I... So I can walk across it instead of that half slab of cobble, which looks awful. You know, had I come out here in the nighttime, I would have been able to find some slimes. Oh! Oh, what is?
You know, did you?
Maybe find some cave drunks down there. Let's go check it out. I miss my dog. Comfort food here. Miss my dog. I'm going to eat some carrots. A couple. So, the cliffhanger thing, and I continue to do that because it's... supposed to keep you interested in the show. And that's been happening to me, and I hate it. American Horror Story is what I've been watching lately. I'm on the first season. It started out bad. I didn't really like the first episode. And you know what I'm not doing? Putting out torches. If I can find my way home. Whoa! Okay. Hole in the ground. That's adventure. But I don't want to go too far, because I want to... Looking for like a big old ravine or witch hut. I don't know anything really. Now let's go down into this hole over here. Because it looks like a deep one. And then we'll maybe find some coal. At the very least, I need some coal. Where is it? Right here. This one looks like a good one. What is that? No, it's just water. I don't like big drop off. Ooh, is that a hole right there? I don't like big drops. Let's go over here. So anyway, so then you'll know if I do leave off with a cliffhanger, which I am want to do, then you'll know at least when the next episode will be, and you can be prepared for it. Oh, look, there's a water thingy down here, a little waterfall. I think I hear bones. Iron, nice. But I need coal. There we go. There's some coal. I'm back out this way now. And more iron. So that's one of the things will be. I'll grab that sand, in fact. Schedule, so you guys know when to expect things. And I would like to get back to Indie Test Drive. That's a lot of fun to do, and I love indie games, and I would love to share those games with you. So I will definitely get back to that. Skyrim, I'd like to do at least one a week, so if I do happen to... Oh my gosh. What? Did anybody see any sheep as I was walking around? Because I wasn't paying much attention. Talking about caveman story. I probably passed a gaggle of sheep. Nice. Nice indeed. Full. Let's get all this iron. So Skyrim, continue. And again, if Wednesday is roleplay day, I would do something like say tutorial Tuesday, and then on Tuesday I'll do a tutorial. And then indie game test drive on Friday, or Punchwood Island, or Minecraft on Monday, or something like that. So it's just a general schedule. It's all that walking around up there. There's nobody home. Everybody's at school. It's lunchtime. Must be my wife. But that's not her walking. That sounded like a kid walking. Interesting. Go check that out. A moment after I get this coal. Do I have any dirt to get across here? Oh, that's wood. And I do not. I don't think I'm ready to go down there just yet. I want to stay on the surface here and try. Ow. But this is a good find. All right, yeah, we can come back here another time. Let's just get out of here. I want to head back. I think it's time to head back. Go get some projects done back at home. And I need to go. I need to go west. Go west, young man. This away. So that's it in a nutshell for 2013. We're gonna see a few changes on the channel, so you guys can expect to see that stuff coming down the pike. I'm gonna sit down and make a list of things that I want to do and achieve with the channel, and you'll see a lot of old stuff. You see a little bit of new stuff. One of the new things I really want to do, looking forward to, is Minecraft, my dwarf fortress. It's gonna be a big project, but hey. I ain't going anywhere. I got plenty of time, and that's what I'm going to work on. So, oh, did anybody see any sheep? Right, let's head back, and maybe we'll see some sheep. So, there's no rush, and, well, you know me. I don't rush. I'm level 15 in Skyrim, and it's been a year. It's the journey, my friends. Not the destination. It's my philosophy. Yeah, this is interesting. Have I? Yeah, this is my jungle. My jungle. Let's go. Wow. Ah, nice window. That's cool. Wait, is that just waiting to fill? Or is that really there? It's there. You know, sometimes when you... There's like a big mirror, and you don't know it's a mirror. And you're like, hey, let's go over into that room. Like, sometimes restaurants would do that to you, and you walk over there, and then you realize when you get closer, oh, it's just a mirror. Oh, hi, dog. I might need a new one. I think my other one's buggered. I got two shots at this. Hi, Poochie. Right. Whoa. Hole in the ground. Here. Hole in the ground. What that means I must mark this hole in the ground with a torch. Here. And whoa, I'm starving again. Alright, well, I have another dog. So that's okay. I really only wanted to have one of each aminal, but what the devil? My other one's bugged and I don't know what's going to happen to him. Hope he gets better. I want some steaks here. You my friend? You're just a weird dog. Okay, look at this. Still no sheep. I don't even think I can carry anything else anyway, so even if I do find sheep, I can't carry their wool right now. I'm full. Alright, it looks like we're home. I see a torch. And why don't we... I'm going to call it quits for now. I'm going to go through my inventory and get organized. Go introduce this dog to Yukon, the stuck dog. And I'll take it from there. There's a zombie. Sounds like he's coming from over here. Well, my other dog is still barking. Oh, there you go. You're better now. Okay. What happened there? Maybe the chunk got unloaded and now, well, guess what? We have a new friend for you. It's a nameless smut. We'll think of something. Come on in, nameless. Okay, never you mind. I'm sure he'll just teleport right in anyway. All right, I'm going to go down here and end it for now, and then we shall return in the near future. Whoa, what's going on with the zombies out there? Because it's zombie night, and it's feeling right. All right, enough of the singing. And ooh, we got lots of steaks to cook. Lots to do. And I'm going to do all that off camera. So, all right. Anyway, I'll see you guys next time, guys and gals. And I hope you have a wonderful 2013. And stick to those New Year's resolutions if you can. I know I'm usually good for about a week or two. And then right back to the norm. And I hope you last a little longer. All right. A for effort, right? All right, we'll see you guys later. Bye-bye. Spider. Kill it. There you go. Take the string. Another one. Come on. Not paying you to stand around and do nothing.